My shoes untied.
My shoes are
Hey,
tied.
It says, oh, did we start on time or what?
It is. We are right on time.
Look at that. All right.
Hello, everybody.
So we were actually running a little behind schedule because we just spent $45 on a webcam to give you guys 1080p. Look at Paco's fuzzy as hell. Yeah, 1080p. So, we got to back the 240 out real quick. We're going to put it in the other way so it's easier to pull the engine and trans out. We have our 2016 Toshiba laptop that Paco's firing up, which we use to respond to any
comments.
Questions, comments, thoughts. Man.
If anybody's watching and check if the chat thing is working, please. Should be able to chat right on the YouTube thing. There's like a button.
Let me see.
That adds like chat.
Were, hold on, see, so right now what I'm doing is I'm checking it. Oops, wrong camera. Up there, we went down here to the laptop when you guys are up there. So it's starting a few moments.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine now.
All right,
so our old antique prehistoric laptop is firing up. As you can see, we're here at Rufus Garage and Laundry. For you guys, last time tuning in, we ripped the inside of the car apart, which was awesome because Paco was the man at disassembly. I kind of hung out a little bit.
Corey did everything with
Crescent
Wrench.
Well, that sounds really nice. The thing, that's a Windows unit.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we wanted to start on time.
I have a schedule for today.
So real quick, I saw 3:30 was coming up fast our time, you know, because we're 3:30 in Arizona here, and I was like, dude, we have to start this like ASAP. Yeah. I don't care if we're still talking about Angelina Jolie after she got her boob cut off.
Oh, dude.
He told me about that because
biggest catastrophe
up,
in story
popped up
history.
On YouTube. But yeah, I had this thing with everybody complaining about FD posting like 5-10 minutes left on the live stream. No, not here. I don't even care if we're still
naked,
you know, because our laundry machines are over there. So anyways, here we are. We're gonna start backing this stuff out, and then we're gonna start trying to rip this engine out.
Just want to check that the chat is working properly, so bear with us for a little bit. And oh nice, we have like 10 viewers.
Nice. Hey, thanks guys.
Hey guys, if anybody can check if the chat thing is working on the stream and send us messages through there. It should be.
Also, on that note, guys, if you guys tuned in from last time, we're constantly checking Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and now Paco, our IT guy, he installed a chat option so you guys can talk amongst each other, and you guys can pretty much say how terrible I am at taking cars apart. And
if you want to send us a message or something on
hashtag.
Facebook, on Twitter or Instagram, remember to use the hashtag Roofless Garage.
Spell that.
Roofless Garage.
That's not how you spell garage. That's not how you spell garage, Paco. So I'm thinking about running new wheels for next year, guys. I just picked these up. These are off.
Oh, they're Supra wheels.
They're Supra wheels?
Yeah, they're Supra wheels.
So I'm thinking about running these things.
That'll be good. That'll be very cool.
Tire size is a 235/60/14. So I'm going with a 14-inch wheel to give me a little bit more giddy up, if you know what I'm saying. A little bit more bite. A little more side bite. This is from the last teardown. This is the fresh. Look at this, guys. Just check this out. Look at how good. Look what the size is up to.
Still. 14 viewers.
Hey, guys. Hey,
it looks like the chat's not.
The chat's not working?
I don't know, but let's find out. Okay. Bear with us, please.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna set the doors outside. Oh, fuck! Oh, God, man. One of the best things you could do is replace the freaking doors, dude. I think it weighed like 6,000 pounds. Paco's checking. As you can see, Paco over here is on the IBM. How am I going to turn this thing off the steering wheel?
We took the steering wheel off.
You can just like kind of like put it back in there.
Oh, okay. It's that easy.
Shit. We threw it away.
Did we?
We have another steering wheel right there. It might work.
All right. That's good.
All right. Oh, there's the chat. Hey, what's up, guys?
Jeez. I almost blew out my...
Let's see if I can get the chat here. So see, like, there's another chat over there.
What?
All right, so there it is. There's people right there.
Get out of that door. See, the thing is I can come over here, and this is instant broadcasting, and then I can just watch what I just did because there's a 30-second delay. That was awesome! All right, let's see this.
Let's see if we can put the other computer in here, maybe.
YOLO.
I would put it on the side.
Oh, Prop Dustin just got called up by Michael McKenzie. Let's
put it over here.
With the big lift. On that, get the Crop Dustin squat on.
Alright,
so dudes, okay. So a lot of times, especially from the last thing we did with this whole teardown, we try to talk as much as we can. You know, we try to answer questions as much as we can. You know, a lot of times, if you guys don't want to watch, put it down in the background. You can leave, listen to Puff on my bullshit if you want to watch us make fools of ourselves, or more so me. Yeah, leave it up. So, have fun with it. Now you got to push this turd out.
All right.
Hold on, I got to move this shit right here.
I have it locked in the way.
Oh, fuck.
Man, we're stupid. Throwing away the original steering.
Oh!
The Supra wheel works.
Does it?
Yeah.
Let's see if we get these people to watch us back it out and try to do a U-turn with the car and the steering wheel.
All right. Move the camera so you can see.
Let's do this! Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to turn the car around so we have a better spot for the lift. Oh, shit. Roofless garage. Let me turn you around. Do, 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 do.
Look at that.
Okay.
It doesn't fit very good.
It doesn't fit very good? Oh, we almost lost the tripod already. Yeah, there's my hand. All right, I think we're good on this in there, Pac, so we can back her on out and do a donut.
Let's me. Gonna need.
All right. I can see myself now. I can see.
Nailed it.
See, every time I work on a car, I usually warm up with a dance. Just gets my blood moving in my legs. And just makes you feel good.
Get that blood flowing.
Okay, let's see here. Got to move that back just a little bit more. What the fuck am I getting stuck on? There we go.
All right. Should we pull some of this shit out? Or the car just leave it in it?
Anyways, guys, what we're doing now is we're gonna back the car out. I kind of said this earlier. We're gonna back the car out. just so we can turn it around so we can have an easier way to roll the engine out of the car using the lift. And the thing that I forgot is I'm running a Grip Royal steering wheel in the car, and I haven't picked it up yet, or I haven't got the hub yet. So I was an idiot and threw away the stock wheel. So we don't have a steering wheel in the car, so we're trying to figure out how I can turn it, maybe with some vice grips or something, but that should be neat. Maybe I'll crash it into a neighbor's house.
Yeah, I'm probably going to use some vice grips instead.
Real quick, I want to grab the laptop. We already got questions, Paco. While you get that steering wheel situation figured out. All right, let's start hitting off with some questions. Power. That's a good name. Nuck-chorus? Nuck-chorus. That's a pretty awesome name.
Nice.
Hashtag power grunt. Sounds like you're giving birth to a gorilla. I had Chipotle earlier. I think I gave birth to a burrito. That stash, though, by Ty Frank. What's the S30 Datsun out front?
That's mine.
The S30 Datsun out front, that is Paco's. He's actually just swapped the 1J in it right now, so we have everything off the front.
We'll show you guys in a little bit.
Yeah, but we'll show you guys that in a little bit. So that's going to be Paco's drift car, and also he has the van over here that he's building up. So once again, use the chat, guys. We're going to move this car real quick, and then we'll start the disassembly.
Keith?
Keith?
Looks like it's locked.
Yeah, keys are on the trunk, or I thought. Oh, right here.
Let's see if it fires up.
You good? I can start rolling.
Yep. All right.
Here we go, guys. Here comes the.
Should I get behind it?
Oh, fuck. How am I going to stop it?
That's okay. Not the e-brake.
Do we? And here it comes. Dun, 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 dun.
Really? I don't mind lining it up. That's straight. Alright, let's move the camera. I can't see with.
When you pull it in.
What's that black thing?
Which one? Oh, yeah. Move that out of the way.
People can see how we die when I got in there. Thank you.
behind you, Jay. Woo! Woohoo!
Nice. Oh, that's a little heavy.
High five, Paco. Okay. You know, people do that at high five, but they actually don't know what to do, so they just shake it.
Hey, put it
in. No, I wanted to fist pound. I wanted to fist pound instead of a knuckle.
All right. Good stuff.
Let's get the engine crane situated. A lot of trains, and cherry picker. How many people's watching?
I'm trying to figure out the chat. Is the chat supposed to be popping up on this?
It's right there.
We have 23 so far, just starting, so that's good. Thank you guys for tuning in. This is where we
feel free to share the link.
I'm working on a car.
Corey, you don't need it.
Yeah. All right, so you need the hoists. Oh, see, from here on out, you guys are not going to be able to see our faces.
Cable. Up and over.
There you go. So for this whole episode, we're only doing shots from the neck down, so you guys won't see our faces at all. Dude, Ty Frank says he needs to teach us some splits, which I give him props because he's the only dude I know that can do splits. Don't forget, guys. I forget the camera's over here. I keep looking at the wrong camera. Hashtag Roofless Garage. Facebook, Instagram, Corey Osford, Tofu Drift Van. This is where we start. The disassembly.
Probably move the camera a little bit further.
It has a weird angle.
It's kind of like a not so narrow.
And you know what I should do, actually? I think during this episode, I'm going to give away a Hoonigan sticker care pack.
That'd be nice.
That. Hand out some like Hoonigan stuff, maybe some sticker packs and all the other shit I got. Okay.
Chat test. All right. Cross shots. Ty Frank knows how some splits for sure.
Okay. So, this engine here is fucking nice.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to take this off.
So nice that we got to take it out.
All right, so
hey, just a heads up, guys, I've never taken a motor out of this car before. I've never taken a motor pretty much out of any car. So Paco here is going to give me the 101 on how to properly remove an engine.
Well, properly?
Or we can hook it up to the truck and just rip it out.
Jank it.
You know what hashtag we should use? Hashtag Fat Nation.
Fat Nation.
Yep, instead of Stance Nation, we're Fat Nation.
I love some Fat Nation.
Okay, so where are we starting?
Let's start like removing battery. Let's get like air conditioning lines off.
Okay, you hit air conditioning lines off. I'm gonna bring this. Should I bring the camera closer?
Sure.
Let's see if I can get you guys more involved with what we're doing here. Now that we got the car in place.
Alright.
Let me get that up.
Battery's out.
Oh, fuck.
People's watching the floor.
Yeah. Why does it seem crooked?
Because.
There we go.
Wait. This is a.
There we go. Oh, it's a knob.
Yep.
Let's get it back just a hair. Sorry, guys. I know you're. Whoa. This thing is.
Yeah, don't open it too much.
All right, hopefully you guys enjoy that.
Let's try to
12 here. All right, so okay, so as you get that set up, here, where's the... All right, guys, so a couple questions as Paco's finishing up there. We had a 2F performance comment. 2F performance, chat test. That guy's an idiot.
That's me, dude.
Oh, fuck, my bad. What engine is going in? 2JZ. That goes out to Jeremy Howes. Michael McKenzie. They're going to put an Aztec engine in it. God, that would be the best. Holy shit, man.
Dude, I don't think it'd be allowed such beast of an engine.
We would go all-wheel drive. We'd go all-wheel drive, Aztec power, Pontiac powered.
Boom.
Did Paco do drift idiots? No, actually, if we're lucky, hold on.
How's the question?
Fuck. Yeah. No, Paco did not do drift idiots. Paco does tofu drift van. Sam Nalvin does drift idiot, and he actually might stop by today. So you get some drift idiots.
I just help him every now and then.
Not with a turbo by Garrett. Yes.
The what?
We are going to do a turbo by Garrett in this car. Maybe on the Aztec swap that we put in. It burns when I pee. What to do? Burns when you pee. What would you do? How much spaghetti did you eat the day before? And try to put some ice in the front end of it so it can go all the way through. So cool it down with some ice. Maybe try to put a straw. Actually, don't put a straw in there because...
Where was it?
It burns when he pees.
Oh, dude.
That's Jason Clark.
Try a menthol paste.
Start smoking cigarettes? Put some Vicks Vapor Rub on it or Bengay. Mustang 09 Hoonigan sticker kit. Yeah, do you know what? Hold on. I'm going to grab that real quick and show you what I have for you guys. Man, I got my speed socks today. Dude, I just got mine and they are comfortable. I haven't worn them yet. So I'm going to set this thing back down. I feel bad because Paco's already doing things behind me. So I'm going to grab that Hoonigan sticker kit.
Yes, Ty, I helped Sam shooting video and fluffing, which is pretty much go get this, grab that, you know.
So, Hoonigan sticker kit. Let's see what you got in this package. We got a bunch of Hoonigan die cuts. We got some sweet vinyl. I don't know if you guys can see that. Let me get nice and close. Hoonigan vinyl. The die cuts, quite a few of those. And then down below, you got some Death Cheetahs. You got the Hoonigan hits. And then also another thing I'm going to do is I just got the new Gymkhana 7 Ken Block lanyard, which would look amazing on some keys that are on a cool car, maybe a Mustang. So at some point I'll give those away to somebody.
Keep sharing the link for the video with your friends who wanted to check out our little dumb broadcast.
Oh God, there's some good questions.
We should like find a way to put that computer in front. Let's move those wheels.
Yeah.
Let's put them all over here next to the laptop.
All right.
So bear with us, guys.
We're still getting set up, so sorry about that.
Let me step around. Out of the way.
All right, so I'm gonna put these
There you go.
Been over here.
Power grunt.
Yep, power grunt. Getting the question station set up. All right, how's that, Park? Got that?
It's fine.
At least it's closer in range. We can go back and forth. Let me see if I can say something on here. What if I say YOLO? Oh, where's the chat at?
Well, you look.
Dude, that mouse is all fucked up.
No. Go back.
Sorry, guys, running a little technical difficulty here.
Brother, you will comment us 2F if you post in this.
Yep.
So.
Running the stash. Someone likes your stash. Your porn stash.
There was a really good question that somebody asked, and I would like to answer that. I feel like we should move this right here. Question. If you had to choose another FD driver to sleep with, what would you make Frederick Osbo for breakfast? That's a great question. I'd probably take him to Denny's.
Oh, come on. That starts more than Denny's.
I'd get him a Denny's Grand Slam. With one OJ.
Grand Slam sandwich.
Well, no, even one OJ because I'm not paying for a refill. That is who. Any more power? We're from CT2. Do people normally run the stock rear end with bigger, more powerful swaps? And what will be swapped out as well? Well, in this car, the whole plan is to take out the stock 240 diff, which a lot of people do run a welded diff. It's great. I ran a welded diff forever. But, I think once you put a winter quick change diff in the car, that takes your car to a whole nother level. All you guys know Crop Dustin, obviously. Crop Dustin would able to change a winter's rear end gear in about 7 minutes. So you can do a whole diff swap in about 6 to 7 minutes, which, especially when you're on track, it's just nuts. I'd make friends with Bob's with waffles. Would you make him a blue waffle? Belgian waffles. Can Paco take his shirt off from Jason Clark?
Well, maybe.
Yeah.
What do you got? What's he got for offer?
Well, hopefully a Belgian mouth sausage.
Everybody's got a prize.
Denny's, man, I miss living in the States. Dude, where are you at now, Mike? Michael McKenzie?
All right, I should probably help.
Keep firing off questions, guys. We're going to be taking a look. Hashtag Roofless Garage.
Yeah, you should probably help, Corey. That would be nice.
All
right. Can I hurt
this off
right here?
Can I hurt this off?
Yeah.
Do we need this
right here? Don't cut yourself.
Look at it. First piece taken off.
Good job, Corey.
What do you guys think of that?
Nailed it.
You guys like that? Yeah!
Okay, have to get
we can't sew it, can we?
Sauce out of the way. This is gonna be hard.
All right, look at this. I already took that off with my bare hands.
One, two.
All right, so there's that. We got the wrenches up top. We got
some extensions.
Okay, well, I'm pretty much done. I just took my one piece off. Oh, we got a hashtag juicy tooth.
Juicy tooth?
Juicy tooth.
Oh, somebody saw the sticker on the right here.
Yeah. Hey, juicy too. Let's see what else we got here. I'm gonna sit down so I can see you guys. Ow! Oh, that sharp cleaner went up right up my money maker.
That went right up my money marker.
Last year today, Ty Fink, what's up? You're the best. Going to get some Instagram questions. Poolside Cat. Poolside Cat on Instagram, which is a killer name. Engine. What engine are we putting in it? Well, we decided not to put the Aztec engine in it. Paco put the 1JZ into his Datsun. We have the Subaru Flat 4. Is that a Flat
6? Flat 6.
That's going in the van. So it leaves us with a 2JZ.
So,
Poolside Cat, 2JZ.
Man, I just bought a brand new bottle of WD-40.
You don't have any? No, what do we do with the WD-40? We went catfishing with it. Might be
out. No, that was all. I just bought one last week.
That's that up there in the corner.
There you go. Good eye.
All right, so I know there's probably some fishermen logging in. As Paco's kind of doing that exhaust. I went to Bass Pro Shop the other day, and we have a lake in our backyard, which is fun to go fishing. I was on this fishing rant for like a long time, and I wanted to catch some catfish. So the dude at Bass Pro Shop, he's like, dude, don't buy any of this bait. Don't buy this bait. It's 10 bucks. Grab yourself a hot dog and some WD-40. So I got a hot dog. Paco had WD-40. Spray the hot dog down with it, throw it in the water, and literally within 3 minutes,
boom.
Catfish. So, not only does it work great taking exhaust off, you can catch some really mean catfish with some WD-40. And that's hashtag fun fact.
Let's see. What else do I have to get out of here? Let's try to, like, get a... Just get it out of the way.
Yeah.
Get
it. Ow! Sorry. I can't see!
I have the glass.
Next time on Rubik's Garage, I don't have an eye patch on because Paco just tried taking me out.
Arr! We're pirates.
Let's see. Let me see if I can give you guys another angle
of what Paco's actually doing here. Whoopsie daisy. Let me get you guys.
Where's my blade?
So there she is, the 200 horsepower stallion.
200, yeah, right.
200 horsepower.
Horsepower?
Out. Oh, we got fluid.
Fluid alert. Okay.
Let's disconnect this. Yeah, this is science right here, guys.
Is it?
Yep. Oh, Will Parker is on.
Good.
Will my boy Will Parker. How you doing, Will Parker? You want to see a sea walkie-talkie? I can see walkie-talkie. You know I can. Let me see if I can do that.
Do what?
Will, my buddy Will wanted to see me sea walk. Come on. Here, let me get that down there. Oh, look at that.
Nailed it.
240SX and period. That's a period in Seawalk language. 240 Nissan Moonwalk and then stop.
That was for you, Will Parker. I know that we had a dance battle a while back.
Wow. Oh, that was good.
Juicy toot.
Who's doing the wiring? Georgia Panna came in, asked a question, who's doing the wiring? Well, my dudes at Chase Base is going to be doing the harness, and they actually did the harness, my S13 with the SR, and it worked perfectly, and I run a Power FC in that particular car, and literally they made the best plug-and-play system, and so Chase Bay is going to be wiring this thing, so it's going to be freaking awesome, and their product's freaking phenomenal, too.
Yeah.
How are you doing, Corey?
Doing good.
Nice.
Let's see, somebody said hashtag drift pirate. Hi, Cody.
Yeah, there you go.
Yes, there's a sea walkie talkie for Will Parker.
All right, so.
Pro tip. Cut all the freaking wires.
Is that what you're doing? Cut wires? All of them?
No, just one.
All
right. So, Paco's cutting the wiring harness for whatever reason.
No, that's good. I'm just trying to get one wire out of the way.
This is what he's using to work on the car. That's not a bad tool to have.
Yeah, give me a 12 mil socket.
12 mil socket, yes, doctor.
What size? Yeah, that's fine.
So as I was talking to you guys earlier, we're going to be doing a giveaway. I don't know what the contest we should do yet, but I'm going to be giving away a Hoonigan care package, which is basically a sticker kit, and then I'm going to be giving away the new Gymkhana 7 lanyard, which is has been, I kissed it, so it's going to be not worth any more than it already is, but I can just say I kissed it. And then, obviously, a large sticker care pack with every Hoonigan sticker in it. To represent for those guys, because they're awesome. Okay, let's see questions. Let me go.
Let's do kind of like a contest. Let's see, like, they need to share on Instagram, you know, like a photo of the live streaming.
Oh, that is a good idea.
And hashtag
Roofless Garage.
Roofless Garage and Hoonigan. All
right. So, Here's Paco just came up with this, and we'll really
pick,
like it.
We'll pick the best. Instagram.
So, if you want to enter to win the Hoonigan stickers as well as the Hoonigan lanyards, you have to post a picture on Instagram. And I'm looking at the camera; I have half my head in it. But if you want to win the Hoonigan sticker pack and the lanyard, go on Instagram, post a picture of you watching this or of the screen or whatever you want.
Whatever you're doing.
But... Hashtag. I'm gonna write this in here. Roofless Garage, and then tag at the Hoonigans.
And tag Corey and me. Make sure we can see.
Tofu Flip and at Corey Hoster. Let me double check that. Let me make sure my spelling's correct. Going through my Instagram. All right, yep, sending it in. So if you want to win, those are the rules right down there. You have to tag those people in a post of you walking in the show.
Okay, shout out.
Yeah, Caden Campbell. I want to give a shout out to my dude, Alec. Alec, what is up? Internet high five. Put your hand on the screen. High five me. High five, Alec. So thanks for tuning in. That was Caden Campbell.
Oh, that's my buddy. It's an M3.
Oh, there it is. High five. Yeah. Internet high five. Internet high five.
Anybody else posting comments on Facebook? You're working hard, Corey.
Yeah, I'm just trying to stay up to date, dude. I'm going to jump in 1 second.
That's okay.
So where's people watching from?
There. Ooh.
Let us know.
Yeah, let us know where you guys are tuning in from. I know we got some people from Norway. We got some people
in Italy.
In Italy.
In
Switzerland.
Switzerland. Loosening it up.
Yep, just loosening her up.
Man, these engine mounts are pain.
Are they?
They're like not in the right position.
Paco?
Almost there. I'm on me. Right. Get this nut out.
We got people from Northeast Pennsylvania. We got people from Ohio. We got Ed P. Ed P just logged in from England.
Oh,
hey.
Howdy, Mike.
Hey.
Is that the
that was my England dance? So
British dance. Yep.
Oh, somebody from England.
Anybody watching from Mexico for the good old south border?
We got New Brunswick, Canada. Eh?
All right, Mike.
Want to put a 2JZ up in here? Hey, Mike.
That's Australian.
That's Australian.
My Canadian accent is the worst.
Oh, geez, that's a brilliant idea.
Ow!
Gotta grab some out of my car real quick.
All right. Uh-oh. I can only imagine. Let's see. Oh, Will Parker wants a WD-40 flamethrower. Oh, we can arrange that. People from Dallas, Fort Worth, Texas. So you're familiar with the Mitsubishi Starion? Yeah, I love the car. I wish they were more reliable, so more people drift them. But so hard to work on those cars, and parts are pretty much inexistent. I know where's a 2JZ and a bunch of BC internals, just waiting someone to put it together. Oh, nice, Michael. Huh?
Uh-oh.
I think she'll be fine without it.
I'm in love with your cocoa. I'm trying to find my lighter, guys.
Man, exhaust bolts suck. Oh, safety first.
Safety first. Sorry, guys. I had to. Anytime I work in a car, I gotta wear a hard hat. Cause I don't want to get hurt.
Yeah, I already got hurt. Bloody knuckle.
Can I do something? You talk to these guys for a second?
Is that real bad? Try to.
I'm going to work on something here, guys.
Try to lose that one up.
All right.
Motherfucker!
Is that it?
Man, I struggled.
Oh my god!
I struggled with another one.
Holy shit, Paco. Is there all of that? There's only two?
There's one more that we're going to have to leave the car.
I'm in love with you, Coco. Oh, dude.
You got it?
Yeah.
Wow. All right, let's lift the car a little bit. And let's do the bottom one. Let's get the people a wide shot of the roofless garage in use.
I'm in love with your Coco.
Hate that song. All right.
All right, all clear. Coming up, guys.
Going up.
Going up.
Oh, what's the wire?
Paco needs a longer ratchet.
What?
Paco needs. Somebody said Paco needs a longer ratchet. Just look what you.
Yeah, well.
Oh, look at that thing.
God damn. We popped the fuse. Let me get the breaker.
All right, Paco blew a fuse. Paco blew a fuse, so hopefully he didn't burn his lips. Let's see. My cousin has a Supra, not a shitty Supra. Oh.
There's no shitty
Supra. Well, Michael McKenzie, yeah.
There's no shitty Supra.
Yeah, is there such thing as a shitty? Well, here's the thing. Whoa, we got bad focus here, guys. Why did the light just get shitty? So there's no such thing as a shitty Supra. We, our buddy Brett bought what year?
86, 87, I think.
Our buddy Brett bought an 87 Supra. But the thing is if you don't tell people the year of the Supra, they all think it's a Fast and the Furious Supra. So just, there's no such thing as a shitty Supra. Just tell them, oh yeah, I got a Supra. And they'll be like, holy shit. Dude, when you get that car, how much did you get it for? Well, I got it for $1,500, and then they're just gonna lose it. Don't tell me. If you own a Supra, don't tell me here. Wait till you pick them up and let them find out that way.
Going up.
Yep.
Down? They are going down.
Safety.
Safety. Oh! God damn it.
Where's that? Look at this. Yeah, so get in there. Get the last bolt.
Does this chair make me look big?
Ooh, this rack is terrible.
You see it?
Yep. Oh, shit.
You scared me.
I'm in that.
Go. Has anybody ever torn a car out one of these engines before?
Hey, Court, yep. You want to turn around?
Ah! Oh,
you broke it.
I think I got it. Oh, fuck. I thought that was a spider.
All right.
Please tell me you got the ratchet flying on.
It definitely.
please tell me that you got that.
It definitely. Awesome. Yeah.
Okay.
This fucking thing. I've dropped this 6 times.
Oh, that's tight. Oh, that's tight. Righty tighty, let's stick to the basics. Righty tighty, lefty loosey.
Lefty loosey.
All right, so hey guys, you want to know a quick tip to learn how to gain horsepower? Let me show you. Let me show you. You guys are going to love this.
You guys are gonna love this. What's that?
We're doing some solid middle longer ratchet.
Oh fuck, Paco? Hold on a second.
What?
I think I may have, there we go.
Kaden Campbell asks, how much does a car lift like that cost?
Oh!
Like 1500. Oh, there you go.
So if you guys want to make horsepower, put this on your car. Look at that.
Look at that hole right there.
That's performance. If you guys want horsepower, let the exhaust breathe just a little bit better.
So what you do
is you put, see that? You don't find that anywhere else. That's American made right there, boys and girls. This I'm gonna put this on eBay. What should we put this on eBay for?
$1.
$1. Should we see if there's any of the buyers?
Maybe.
Buy it now. $1 and $40 shipping. It could be this performance exhaust could be yours, or. Do you know what I want to be, Paco?
What?
I want to be the Gallagher of the car world.
Smashing just, shit.
Oh, you ever seen an exhaust before? Oh, me neither. Ah!
Our neighbors are gonna love. Yeah. All right, get out of there. Ah!
Cool.
Time to bring the car down, man. That was quick.
Is there anything? Dude, I knocked that out. Oh, you know what? No, wait. We still have to remove the
trans.
Transmission, get me a 12 ratchet. Oh, I think it's up here. And wanna check up there, Corey? Oh, I think it's 12.
Okay, hold on. Where are you going? Whoa. Why are you back there not letting these guys
realize?
Here.
All
right, guys, let me get you down here.
We have this disconnected from the tripod.
Here's Paco working on his knees, guys.
That's how he makes a couple bucks.
What?
I have mouths to feed. Two.
Okay. Let's see here. Trying to go through questions and comments, guys. I don't have an Instagram. Hey, Jeremy Howes, I know you don't have an Instagram. If you have Facebook or something like that, just try to figure out a clever way, and we'll just figure it out. More comments below. Plano, Texas. 30 people are on. All right, so Paco, let them know what you're doing.
I'm removing the drive shaft. But I need to turn the wheels a little bit.
Is this what it feels like to work on a car?
Wheel block. Oh, camera's gone.
Yep. Aim it back. Turn it a little more.
I need it.
What do you need?
Get up here. Get up there too.
Okay, perfect. I'll be right there.
There you go. Perfect.
This is why I wear hard hats when I work on the car.
Do you want that? Do you want that chair?
No.
No? No, I'm good.
We should give, do you know what I was thinking of? Is there anything off this car we can give away to people?
What? There's nothing if people want. Is it?
Yeah.
Or people can tell us in the comments.
Yeah, hey, do you guys, okay, so how about this? Let me roll my way back in here. You guys can see me. So we want to make you guys a part of the show, right? You guys are a big part of this build, and you'll see this thing everywhere on the internet, hopefully, when it's done. But we're going to give away parts of the car. We should find out a way to give away parts of the car so you guys can feel that you are a part of this whole build, which you guys are. So if there's anything that you guys see that is worth shipping out in the mail
that you want
in
the comments.
Yeah. Or we can do contests and stuff for them.
Like chairs? Musical chairs?
Musical chairs. We should do an internet arm wrestling competition.
There you go. That's called a YouTube comments.
YouTube comment. Everybody fights. Wow.
Drive shaft
is nice.
Let's see, Mustang, Jason Clark, I can smoke out on it, Mustang out, Ty Fink, I used to go to Liberty Hood High School, Block. What car really things did you want for Christmas?
Transmission mounts are really good, man.
Let's see, hold on, we got a question, what would I want for Christmas?
Watch that shit on the floor.
Oops. What the fuck is that?
Crap.
What do I want car-related stuff for Christmas?
Where's that?
A G-Force transmission, a 4-speed dog box, Winter's quick change, a new subframe, solid diff bushings, Brian Crower stroker kit, Turbo by Garrett 4088 GTX series. What else would I want, Paco? Turbo manifold, the 2JZ turbo manifold, some new harnesses, some new seats, grip royal steering wheel, probably like $20,000, $30,000 and stuff. We're rich, remember?
Right. I'm losing my life savings.
Luke Poirier, giving away parts. I would love 2JZ parts. We all want 2JZ parts. All right, so Paco guys just took out the drive shaft. We're going to the transmission mount, and then we're grabbing the engine hoist and pulling the engine all the way. And then we're good to go.
Nice. Impact.
Do you need an impact or can I just get on it?
Yeah.
Do you have the right size? It's a 14? Is that all it is?
Yeah, we need a...
Is that what size it is? A 14? That's bigger than a 14.
That's 17. I have it right here.
Give it to me. I'll give
but some. I need a...
Let me see if I can get my my touch on it. You need what?
Impact guns right here.
You don't need impact on that?
Yeah.
Ooh!
Let's get more power.
There you go, Corey.
All right, sweet. The pleasure is mine.
We gotta get loud.
Yep, sorry guys. In advance.
The center ones?
Uh-huh. This is a 14.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's a 12. Yeah. I
think it's up
here. Oh, it was here. Oh, there you go.
I am freaking tired, guys. I need more coffee.
Okay.
There you go. One hand on that. Okay, let's see if I can.
There's a two.
You're the world's longest ratchet.
Let's remove the slave cylinder over here.
There you go.
That's it.
Am I on the wrong one? Yeah, there you go. Yard cell. Oh, nice. And let it blow.
Just use one. Just use one.
Oh, man, but I like having it 30 feet long.
What are you compensating for, Corey?
I don't have any tools. All right.
One, two.
You want to check out comments on the computer?
Sure. And after that, remove these two for the slaves.
Right.
With this one. Right. Let's check out comments.
You move the camera and aim it on you, too.
That's okay.
I know. I don't want.
They don't want to watch you.
They want to watch you.
They want to watch you working, Corey.
They don't want to watch you.
Can't believe it. All right. Mustang's asking, is it going to be a missile car, or do you want to do a nice paint job and keep it clean?
It's going to be the goal. Yeah, tell him the goal.
All right, this car is going to be Corey's Formula Drift 2015 car. Oh, shit. There you go. So this is a new Formula Drift car. It's going to be rocking next year. So it should be pretty clean, pretty nice. We will see the death of Corey Hosford.
What?
People trying wanted you to die or something. Like,
oh, yeah. I pull this out and watch the freaking engine just fall on my face.
Fall on your face.
Okay, sweet. That's off.
Let's see what else we have to take out.
I'm impressed.
Out.
Drive the steering on?
Transmission's out. No, same thing.
Okay. It literally just comes down to the trans, huh?
Wiring.
What's this right here? This come off right here?
Yeah, I feel like this can, like, as long as we can. Hope so.
That's all good.
All that other stuff out.
Good.
Wiring. Okay. All our athletics. What is it? Oh, shit. There's a bracket here.
Look at it. Paco, look how they look on camera.
Masculine?
No, just look at it. Turn around. Look. It's like we're almost scissoring them. Whoa! PG-13.
All right.
This is going to be the missile card. I tweeted my entry, Jeremy. We'll check out your tweet. You're down there now. Get back to you there. Same here.
They want me to say something. Don't forget this, too. They want me to say something. We'll see the death of Corey Hosford, Ron Burgundy voice. I can't do that. I don't even know what Ron Burgundy sounds like. Michael McKenzie, you're the best. Legends never die. Soon he's talking about you, Paco.
Out of your eyes, dude.
Yeah, no. Nah.
You love that, huh?
I don't really have to even use my legs to go anywhere.
10 mil. This is the last one.
I haven't touched a crescent wrench all day.
Oh, you know how that works, yeah. Son?
I haven't touched a crescent wrench all day. We're coming down to pulling the trannies mount.
And by trannies, we mean transsexuals.
They want 2,000 horsepower.
God damn right we do. Yeah. Stupid speed sensor.
Checking Instagram.
Corey?
Yeah.
The only thing missing is removing the shifter.
Yep.
Up there. So let's put the car down.
Yep.
And,
Wow.
That was beautiful, Corey.
Thanks. All right, so we're going to lower the car down. We got to do the... So hold on. What did we do so far? We removed all the wiring.
Disconnected the exhaust.
This exhaust.
The drive shaft.
The drive shaft came out. We have to take off the shifter. And then literally undo the tranny bolts. And then we're done. This is actually... like less stuff than I. Why did I think it was gonna be way harder than this?
Have you done it before?
I've never done it before. Is that car you're working on a 5-speed? Just bought a 1998 S14 Cookie, and I'm looking for 5-speed parts. Chase Smith. Yes, it is 5-speed. Came that way stock. Thank you very much. Stock. Let me grab this right here.
Let's see. I think we're done down here.
There you go. Now I can see. All right. Corey, this is from Sweet and Low. Corey, what kind of racing would you do if you didn't drift? Well, fun fact, okay? I've done tons of racing for you guys. I started racing go-karts at 6 years old. Born and raised down in California. Started racing go-karts at 6 years old. Ran go-karts all the way from 6 years old to about 18 years old-ish.
You could have fit
my first professional race was in go-karts, actually. And then I started doing more pro auto sports, NASA, SCCA. I started getting into, like, sedan racing. Road racing was fun. Then I worked at the Bonnerat School for 13 years with whatever, yellow. My brother races sprint cars, and I by far think the best form of racing is 360 or 410 non-wing sprint cars, and that's what I love to be doing. Or don't forget this too, said I could be horse drifting.
A junkie.
I rode a horse once, and every time I hopped on it would pee. I don't know if that was just the horse. Maybe overheating, and it was letting some heat.
Yeah, it was overheating.
Overflowing, but yeah, every time I ride a horse, it pees for some reason. Michael McKenzie, oh, seriously, I missed you guys not being in FD. Seriously, the off-track with Jensen Argyle talking to strangers was some of the funniest shit I've ever seen.
Dude, off-track was great.
Off-track was really good, and Dustin is always the best on camera.
Contact Network A and tell him we want off-track back.
Yeah, Dustin is the best on camera. But the thing is, and Dustin's going to be on one of these, hopefully within the next week when we do something else. But if you ask Dustin, hey, Dustin, let's go beat Jensen Argyle Chip Keys, he'll be like, nope, you can't tell him that you want to do it. He just has to do it.
It's so natural.
It's natural. It's crazy.
He's a method actor.
Dude, honestly, you want to give away a part? One of us guys would like the shift knob if you don't keep it. The shift knob in this car is actually really good. It's really cool. I'll show you guys. Maybe I'll give it away because I don't need it.
Right behind you.
Yep, come down. Drag racing. I did used to race junior dragsters too when I was a kid. I used to race junior dragsters.
Junior dragsters sound like a lot of fun, man, if you're young.
Okay, so the thing about junior drag racing, I did that when I was a kid. You would do one run, and it's like 14 seconds long, and then they don't run you again for another 4 hours. So you do 15, it's 15 seconds of racing, and then you wait 4 hours and you do another 15 seconds, and then you pack it up and go home, and then you spend $3,000 to get there. Corey, you guys ever down the street drift?
No.
No, I haven't. Don't tell anybody, but I'd like to. We'll keep it on the DL.
The only time I accidentally street drifted, actually, was when I had my Miata. I was on the airport. I was going to pick up my mom, and it was pouring rain like cats and dogs.
Literally cats, German Shepherds.
So I was running around the airport waiting for my mom to arrive, and I saw like something on one of the little turns. I was like, oh, let's just get it out of the way. The little Miata started skidding. It was like, oh, and boom, right into the curb. Spend the wheel in.
Mom, I want to be there in like 3 hours. I'm going
to call my sister. Hey, can you go come to the airport, pick up my mom? Stop.
Well, okay, so I got one. I was, my first car, okay, was a 1967 Volkswagen Bug.
Nice.
Yeah, it was cool. You know, my parents got it for me for like $400, and that was my budget. It was a $400 car. And it wasn't bad. They got it off one of their mutual friends. They just had it sit in their backyard. It wasn't pretty, but it was still cool. And I remember I was cruising around, and talk about being old, Paco. Uh-huh. I remember putting gas in that car, and it was only 99 cents a gallon.
Wow.
99 cents a gallon.
Oh, yeah. Well. How long ago was that?
Yeah, that was literally
think about it.
15 years ago.
Wow.
Maybe. Okay, so anyways, Volkswagen Bug, first car. You know, I was racing go-karts at the time, and I was doing some sedan racing. And I think it may have been me and Dustin, actually, because I was driving before Dustin. And we went to Blockbuster, and he's like, dude, let's go slide this thing around. So I'm at the Blockbuster parking lot with Dustin in the car, and the headlights – I remember I put the headlights in because they were all messed up to begin with. So I had like one aiming up and one aiming down, so I really didn't see. Started doing donuts in Blockbuster, and it went from oversteer to straight understeer. And I was just driving through the understeer and ripped the whole front end off the car. So I was high-centered on the median with the front end laying on the ground, and I had to call my dad to tow me out. the front is just laying in the
Volkswagen Bug drifting.
Yeah, bring it on. Yeah, so my first drifting experience out of a racetrack was in a Blockbuster parking lot in a Volkswagen that I crashed.
Man, Blockbusters are so much
fuck
fun.
Blockbuster. Oh. Miata, Danny George style.
Yep.
Yo!
That's where Danny got the idea of drifting. I told him my story about drifting at the airport. And he's like, man, I'm going to drift my Miata too.
Yeah. Oh, you went drifting on the airport? Yeah, fuck you. I'm going to get a Miata. I'm going to drift at the airport.
Hey, I'm Danny George. I have a beer. I'm going to drift my Miata. I'll say hi to Danny.
Danny.
Hopefully he's watching.
Can you unscrew that shift knob by chance?
Huh?
Can you unscrew that shift knob?
Do it? Yeah. Four holes. Yep. Let's bring the audience.
They want to see this. Hey guys, so I know you guys are asking about the shift knob. We can give this away. Look at the shift knob, guys.
It's a Razzo.
It's a Razzo.
But look at this.
Look at this. Yep, go ahead, show them.
There you go. So, you got it?
Yep. It's got a secret stash.
I don't know for what, but We can put some stuff in there. Oh, well, it's got the plastic in it, but you can.
Yeah, whatever that does.
Remove that out, and you can stash your tobacco.
Yep. What the hell?
It pulls out. The center.
The center?
Uh-huh.
Whatever.
Anyways.
So here's a ship knot. We could probably give that away.
Who wants our
Could do that. Let's do that next episode. We'll hang on to it. Next episode, we'll give away. Because right now we have the Hoonigan stuff.
Oh, that's right.
Next will be the Razo ship knob.
So we'll put that on. So you can see it's original, not a replica.
It's not a replica.
There you go. Up, up. Focus. There you go. Real. Razo.
Razo. Italian. It's the only Italian part on this car.
I thought it was Japanese.
It's Japanese.
I don't know. Why do I know?
We're getting close for it.
Yeah, this is it.
I think I need to go on the other side. Pulled that out. Anything happening over there, Pa?
Let's see. Yeah, so let's know that's a sick shift knob.
Yeah, we can give away that shifter. I'm not going to use it. Last little bit here, guys, and this thing is coming out. Anything on Instagram, Paco?
I'll check my Instagram, but I can check it in a second. Let me check mine.
This is what it's like working on the car. How can people have fun doing this?
Let's see.
All right, here's a question. If you guys weren't working on a car or weren't helping me work on my car, what else would you rather be doing? And it can't be drifting or racing a car. It has to be something out of the automotive world. So what would you do other than working on a car?
Holy shit.
What?
All right, so we have people here already.
Come on over to this side. I'll switch sides with you.
Wait. Get my phone over there so people can see the...
All right.
So what's up to John Coros?
Was it?
John Coros.
So we have F Person on Instagram. Got a pretty cool shot right there. Thanks, man. Thanks for watching. Where are you watching from? Let's see who else. Josh B. YT. He's got another one. It's like, got Corey's dirty hand because he's actually working. Thanks for watching, man.
John Corzon said, hashtag Hoonavan. What's up, guys?
What's up, man? Josh?
John.
John. What's up, John? Penny dropping S for teen. That's a killer name, bro.
What is it?
Penny dropping.
Ooh!
Penny dropping S for teen. He... There you go. He got a pretty cool shot of Corey looking like an idiot, and I look like a major idiot.
Did he know this thing was a panty dropper?
Yeah, this is a panty dropper S14. I mean, look at it. Boom.
It's like right there. Ah! They're clean. Panty dropper.
There's some Corey panties in the car. Get out of the way.
Panty dropper.
Thanks for watching, man. Let's see who else in here. Ty Fron. I wonder if this is the same Ty.
Ty thinks he does splits.
Nice.
Split wizard.
Oh, there you go. Yes, he's like showing his split is splitting. There you go. Boom. Good stuff, bro. All
right, Paco shifter. I undid all the bolts.
Wait 1 second. Sweet and low. What's up, bro? Thanks for watching. Look at that. Right there. Boom. Now a couple more on the same. Let's check out the hashtag roofless garage. Let's see who's. Boom. There you go. Same racing. He's wearing a pretty killer beard. So I guess he's winning at the beard game so far. Thanks for watching, man.
Somebody says I still look like the hunter from Jumanji.
What?
Somebody says I 30 minutes later I still look like the hunter from Jumanji.
Hey, what's up, Yannis?
White tea. That was good.
Oh, there you go. So, okay, so John Kouros is actually Johnny. He's watching from Greece. What's up, buddy? How you doing, man?
You know, I asked them what would they be doing if they weren't working or helping us work on cars. Video games, RC cars, flying a plane, even if it's a Cessna or a fighter jet.
A fighter jet would be awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Probably be hanging out with family or more, maybe going to go eat with friends. That's cool, too.
That's pretty badass, yeah. We have
You're a little out of focus, Paco, on this.
I'm drunk. Gotcha. I'm drunk. Saying, go get him, guy. There you go. Oh, look at that. He's watching with his little kid, I guess.
Oh, that's awesome. What's up, little guy? Who is that?
His username on Instagram is go get him, guy.
Did he?
What's your name of your kid, bro? What's up, little buddy?
Did they do hashtag?
Roofless Garage.
Wow, that's awesome. We got to get something for the youngster.
Does Hoonigan make like baby
thingies?
They weren't popular, I guess.
You don't know how many kids blow tires off of cars.
There you go. Mustang's watching as well.
Yeah.
What's up, bro? Oh, look at that. He's probably a Von Gitting fan right there. He's got the monster cap.
Von Diggin Jr. Should I sell my picture of Von Gitting, me dressed as Von Gitting Jr.?
Yeah, you have a photo of you dressed as Von Gitting? Thanks for watching, Mustang. Mustang 09. Let's see what else we have here.
So, here, scoot over real quick.
Scoot up, get in there.
So,
Get a shot.
So, I did a video shoot with Forsberg, Turek, and who else was there? Vaughn. And, here, let me see if I have pictures. I still have pictures of it. But he left all his monster stuff laying around, so I put it on.
I didn't know that.
No. So me and Dustin, we wanted to be Von Gitting Jr. I'll show you Dustin first. By the way, Von has the smallest head in the world.
Wow.
His head is a little pea head. I couldn't get that. That's Dustin with the hat all the way on. It didn't even squeeze on his big old head. Okay. And I'm 7 1/4, 7 1/2 hat size. This is
you have a big melon.
Yeah. This is how I wore the hat. It wouldn't go all the way on my head. It just sat.
See his glasses.
Yeah, those are his glasses.
He was
too.
Looking for his glasses all day. Yeah, he got my glasses.
He Dustin stole. So then we showed him.
Sorry, Vaughn, if you're watching.
We showed him this. We showed Vaughn that picture.
Sometimes I focus a little bit.
So there's that picture of Vaughn, right? So we're like, screw that. How about we do this? We put Dustin's head on his body. It's kind of cool. Little tiny head, Vaughn.
Thanks, Luc Poirier. Is that how you say it? Luc Poirier. Thanks for watching. Little shot right there.
And then here's this. So I was driving the RTRX, which is a pretty cool car, man, if you guys have seen it before. But there's Vaughn wrenching on it for me as I was in the driver's seat. I was like, that's a total role reversal. Oh, you're going to work on my RTRX. Thanks, dude.
Let's see.
This is inside the RTRX.
I dropped it like for a couple seconds only.
It's kind of hard to see, but pretty cool stuff. Good guy. Love that guy, actually. Went to his house in Maryland, watched his buddy total a Subaru, took his razors out.
Oh, that STI.
Yeah.
How's comments on YouTube? Great
work for Monster.
So there's Corey watching.
Hey, and the boy's name is Wade Michael William.
The what?
Wade. The kid that's watching with his dad is
Wade. Oh, nice.
We call it Pacoism and try to not to crack too.
What?
They say they go Paco. When I first heard Ruthless Garage.
The Pacoism.
Yeah, we call it Pacoism and try not to correct him too often.
Blackboard of Sex is John. John Landy. What's up, Johnny boy?
That's funny.
So Ruthless.
Ruthless Garage.
Ruthless Garage.
So, want to do a little shout out for a buddy?
You could give him a shout out.
Let's give a shout out to our good friends from K-Sport. K-Sport makes very good coilovers for a very affordable price. And that's what we're putting. Let me show you guys a little bit. What we're putting right here in the tofu van. Right now, the
what happened to your...
it needs to reload.
The computer's like dying or something.
So let me show these guys. So made this tubing cage thing, which bolts into an S14 soft right now. So we're gonna put these K-Sport coilovers right here, and the van is gonna be able to use all Voodoo 13 control arms and anything made for S14. Like right now, let me show you. This is pretty cool. Let's see. So I got these are my dual caliper brackets made by Maverick Motorsports. Look at it here in Arizona. They're like super, super nice, high quality aluminum machined adapters. They were great. I mean, like you can see, like you can just put both Z32 brake calipers, and it uses a Mustang Cobra rotor, which actually I was surprised how easy and cheap they are to find. And then I have my ISIS Performance fine log adapters. Thank you, ISIS. I got these guys actually from ASAP Motorsports, our friends here in Phoenix. If you want some parts for your 240, go to aceupmotorsports.com. And we also have Hosworth's Hosworth Performance is about to start selling online stuff for all kinds of cars, particularly drift cars tell us about Hosworth Motorsports, Corey.
Hosworth Performance.
There you go. There you go. Boom. You're live, Corey.
Oh, hey, how's it going?
I didn't see you guys there.
Yeah, sorry, we got the computers restarting, guys, and then we're literally pulling out the engine now.
As we're starting.
Hosworth Performance. If you guys need parts, let me know. Plain and simple, so.
All kinds of parts.
Whatever.
So we're about ready to pull the engine up. Let me get this out of the way. So for that, we need to lift the car up so we can slide this thing in there.
Get rid of this sweet exhaust system.
Oh, look what I found.
Probably Corey lost throwing stuff down.
Yeah. And also, guys, our computer is restarting, so bear with us.
Oh, we have John on the line. John, what's up? How you doing? Ooh, that'll be nice. What about? Let's see. You want something to drink, Corey?
I'm good right now.
Corey's fine. So
like really fine, like sexy as hell.
There you go. Boom. Whatever. Like I mean, whatever.
Paco's doing a phone call, guys.
They don't sell it anymore.
They don't sell it anymore.
Yep.
So, yeah, don't worry.
Cool, cool.
All right, man. That's an order, bye. All right. So let's see if we can get the hoist in there. Lift the car a little bit more. What's up, dude?
Just going through it. All right, your computer's starting up.
Oh, but the, it's still streaming.
Oh, hey, I thought the stream was off.
No, dude.
The computer's...
That's totally independent.
Yeah,
it is. It's getting cold. We got a rainstorm coming in.
You want to adjust the camera or something?
Yep.
Let's do it. Where do you want to put tripod? It? Probably like looking this way. So
let's see the...
All right, let's... Where's my tripod-y?
I tried porta potty.
Welcome to Jumanji. Here it goes, guys. We're getting close.
Japan just started
streaming.
It's like, no, it's
yeah, cool. After Japan, go for it.
You guys want to watch some good Japanese drifting?
We'll even turn it on as well.
We're almost done pulling the engine out.
So it works.
Which is a lot more fun. crank it up a little bit higher.
Dude.
There's
Scoop
a ratchet. Hey, Corey, I see the
ratchets on that side? Yeah. Corey? Yep. Ratchet. Oh, there you go. So Jared's dropping a Diego Santos on the FD Japan stream.
There you go.
Yeah.
I wonder who runs that.
Diego? It's Diego, man. Best Mexican drifter from Japan.
Best Mexican drifter.
Yeah. Give Diego Santos a shout out. He's probably not watching as he's running FD. FD Nippon. Remember, guys, this video is going to be available to watch on our channel after we're done live. So in case you miss something or you want to just like check something that you wanted to see or show your friends or whatever, feel free to go back to my channel and check it out over there.
All right.
Go that side.
And then literally, we got to still get the trans mount.
Transmission's not already. Did you put the shifter on?
Yeah. I got to pry it up with a screwdriver.
Yeah, try to get everything out of the way. Should
be good to go. I haven't read many comments. I know that we missed a lot of computer stuff.
The what?
I know we missed a lot of comments.
Oh, no, the comments are still there. Don't go too hard. This whole engine is kind of like...
Hard to
shift around. Let me see if I can get from the other side. I think on this side, I'm side. All right, guys, engine's about to come out.
Transmission, we're going to use a G-Force 4-speed dog box in the new build. Let's see here. I didn't realize. Follow Dope Drip on Instagram. All right. What transmission are you guys? Have you seen my son's phone? We're going to use a shifting transmission that shifts. I just got a Instagram from Scumbag Alec. Look at this. This is kind of... Look at his shirt, Paco. You see his shirt?
Yeah, it's a hoonigan.
Yeah, look at mine.
Boom!
We're twins!
He's a twin.
Sweet. Sorry, guys. Sorry for the downtime here. We're just... I could bring the camera around and show what's going on, but the tranny...
See this.
Now, just a pickup. Just put a pickup on my Instagram. Scumbag Alec, we saw you, dude. We're twinning right now. See, I got my hand. We could be the part of the Twins Dragons, dude. That's how we do it. So the issue that we're running into right now is...
Moving the shifter.
Because it's not coming out. And if that doesn't come out, it's going to be a pain in the butt. But Paco might have a pen to pry that out. So that's kind of cool. In the meantime, do you know what I could show you guys, actually, is I can show you Paco's Datsun. Is that engine cover just sitting on top of it?
You can take off that plastic cover.
Yeah, let me go take the cover off, and I'll walk you guys over there. Hopefully we don't lose Wi-Fi. So I hope we don't lose Wi-Fi.
It might.
We'll be all right. It's not too far. All right, guys. Oh, fuck. All right. Come with me, people. All right, so this is Paco's Datsun. He just finished fabbing up the front end to put the 1JZ in it, which will eventually have a turbo. VBTI. What's that?
VBTI single turbo.
Yeah, VBTI single turbo. Mod of the whole front. This was protecting the engine from the rainstorm, which looks like it's inbound. Here's Paco's Aztec. This thing rips. That's a wheelie popper right there. But, yeah, engine mounts, everything bolts right in. Transmission, pretty much in the stock location. But
worked on an 18 fab.
Yep, 18 fab. Paco just pulled everything out of this thing because it just got him painting the red cage. We have some, save you guys on some food and stuff. With that newspaper. Boom. And then you're back. Back to Paco.
It got very, very choppy. Definitely went out there. Yep. Like it dropped quality, but it looks like it was working.
Nice. Well, glad you guys are back. I got the shifter out.
Let's do it.
So, it's that time. I have to attach this to. Quiet, Corey.
I know. I'm just thinking. I'm getting excited for one, and we're getting super close. Getting super close, and then once this thing's out, I think. Hey, would you guys want to watch a cage getting built for this thing? I think the next episode is we put a cage in it. We go to 18 fab here in Arizona, and then fab up a whole cage from scratch. Be kind of cool. I never built a cage before, so it'd be a good time to figure it out.
We lower it. Oh, we can lower it anymore.
Is it just sitting on the engine mount?
Yeah.
Here it is, guys.
All right, engine's floating on its own weight. Thank you.
Glory.
There we go.
There we go. So,
what does that do?
It drops a rear. Oh,
nice.
All right. Down a little bit. I think we're gonna have to shorten.
Shorten the what?
That's fine. Let's see, how's the transmission clearing back here?
It's an angle, so.
Yeah, back here is still kind of like. Wait. Watch your hands. Lift it up a little more. Let's see, more wires are still attached.
What about the we have the ground right here. For this.
Yeah, I can just try to unscrew that out of the way.
You have ratchet over there.
12 maybe. Yep.
Getting close, guys. Look at this. All right. Just dropped the bolt. Sorry.
This again. Let's see. There's another. One more thing to remove here.
Let's see. Like meat. What should I get on my pizza? Me, on my pizza, I like doing pepperoni and sausage, or I'll do the works with no mushroom and no black olives. I'm not really a big fan. I know Paco on his pizza.
Hawaiian.
Ham and pineapple. How many different license plates do you have?
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26.
28 license plates.
If you guys wanted to send some more license plates, please do.
Yeah, if you guys want license plates hanging in the roofless garage, we'll hang them up. Oh, yeah. Michael McKenzie's like, oh, yeah, fabrication, that's awesome. Just fit it, fabricate, fit it, blah, blah, blah. Seems like a lot of work, but that's one thing I'm not good at.
Fabrication?
Yep.
Yeah, when it comes to fabrication, we limit to the pros. And it's going out, Corey. Where's my rack?
Your rack?
Just in my hands.
A t-shirt to me?
Well, whatever. Those t-shirts are all dirty now, man. So. All right, well.
How much you need?
Let's pump that up. A little bit. Smoke is coming. Wait.
It's getting close. It's wiggling.
Let's see where it's. Wait. Don't pull it from the chain. There we go. All right.
Ready?
Pull out like the whole crane, start pulling it up. All right, keep pulling up. Oh, yeah.
That fan is not.
Just let it go. Just, yeah. All right.
light four way. Wait, wait. Pull it, hold on. No. Pull it down a little bit.
Where's
the... Very, very slow, very slow. All right, wait. Let's pull back. Where's it hitting? Is it on? Let's pull out the clutch, maybe. Get a little. Actually, yeah.
Maybe, can we drop it down back? Can we drop the back a little bit more?
It's all the way down. Let me drop it a little bit. Let's remove the fan clutch. Here, 10 millimeter.
10 mil?
Yeah.
10 mil coming up, doctor.
Coming up. It might be under the car on that side. Oh, it's right here.
Nice.
Yep. You got the ratchet?
Yep. Just pull off the fan itself?
Yeah, just those four right there.
Getting close, dudes.
Fucking hat.
This is why you wear a hard hat, just in case. Sweet.
Jason Clark, what's up, dude? Pump it up.
I need an orange vest to go with my hard hat. I look like I'm the lead singer of the Village People. Were they a bunch of gay mechanics working on that car?
I don't know, get gay bullshit.
What the fuck?
Hey guys.
How do you do?
It's getting dark.
We're almost done.
Yeah.
Then I'll have a KA for sale.
For that. Anybody needs a KA, good shape?
$400.
One more.
All right. And the Ninja Star is off.
Nailed it. All that time, guys, to take that off.
Stock up. Drop it a little bit more. Watch your hands.
Yep. Did you get the four bolts off the tranny mount?
Yeah.
Really?
Well, dude. It's all hanging already. Yeah. I left the tranny mount. I just got the other ones off. It's pulled.
No, it's
from that side. That's on the end.
It might be just the mount itself.
No, let me try something quick. All right, and Corey?
Yep.
I need to pull when I tell you.
Okay.
Yep. And oh,
yeah, some stuck back there, there, dog. So you wait.
Pull it down a little bit. Yeah, just pull it down.
Okay.
Slow. Going down. Go, 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 go. Wait, we get some lights.
Need some lights. Holy cow, this is getting intense. I'm about ready to die.
I get my little flashlight.
Your flashlight?
Flashlight.
Get your flashlight out.
Have some fun with the flashlight. Of course, it doesn't have a battery.
No battery.
Oh, it's right up there. No battery too, nice.
Well, let's see.
You need my cell phone. Yeah.
Dude, flashlight. Roofless garage needs a flashlight.
Trying to go out.
Figure it out. Getting close.
I think it's whatever else he was getting stuck on, he got loose now. So
are you ready? Going up.
Lift it up. Wait. Try to pull up at the same time. Keep pumping up. Hey, just go.
What?
Yeah, just keep going.
Oh, that doesn't swing, hit me in the face. Oh.
All right. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep
going. Oh, hi.
Just keep going.
I think I'm looking hard now. Ready?
Letting it use this.
Can you push down on the tranny with that stick?
No, I see what it is.
What is it?
Pull it down a little bit. Sorry.
Yeah, I need this tool to put it down.
Do it again on the other side.
Oh, that could have been bad. That could have been real bad. I should not be in charge of this. What is it? Oh, you're wiggling it for sure.
Pull up.
Pull?
Yeah. No, the engine.
It's hit the front. I gotta go up with it a little more.
All right, lift it.
There we go.
Okay.
Oh yeah, we're free.
Is it?
It's moving a lot.
Oh yeah.
Tell me.
Oh, wait, no. It got stuck. I'm going to remove the transmission mount.
It's got to free it. So
drop it down a little bit.
Okay.
So it hangs freely.
Fire out. Tell me how low.
Compressor. Thank you.
The legs.
It's free.
All right, here it is, guys.
Well, so lift it up.
We made it.
Keep going. Going all the way.
Watch how
he's gonna pull it there. There you go.
There
so,
it is.
Let's
turn. Let's start a little bit. Look at that. We're fucking right there. We can try this.
Lift it up more.
That way. I could probably lift up the tranny.
I gotta hit that thing. I need to adjust this crank.
Here. There's no way.
Can you just help me turn it that way?
Out of my way?
Yes.
My way?
Oh, no, the other way.
There you go.
One second, let me. Second, I need to take out the handle. You gotta turn it more?
Here, I can push my whole hinge.
Now this stuff hits.
Here, let me see if I can watch it. Can I push a pull? I wonder here. Let me see if we could. Hey, let me see something.
Is that we'll pull that knob down a little bit?
Let me see if I can spin it this way.
This is the slide is hitting, so.
Is that the right way?
Let me.
We're close,
remove the,
dude.
Remove the handle, so.
I think we need to, here, let's
get a little turn it.
Let's get to show these guys what we're doing here real quick. All right, so we're getting to a point here, guys, where the lift is about ready to hit the garage. So we might have to turn it into garageless garage.
Doorless.
Doorless garage.
No hand cord.
Yep.
Turn that thing. Back
there? This way?
Yeah. Okay. Push it from here. No, the other way. Well, let's go that way. Okay, there you go. Okay, that's gonna be better.
Can you watch your hand real quick? Let me see if I can grab the front of this. Watch your hand. Trying to level out the engine right now so we can pull it out.
So this you should put the crank on this side and I forgot. Alright. Let's crank that up a little bit more. Yeah, I need a hand.
Okay, here, let me plug my laptop back in so it didn't die. Okay. All right.
Got it from back here and pull it back. There we go. Holy shit. There
Get close, dudes.
All right. Look at that.
All right, so let's see how much we get.
We gotta have.
We're probably gonna have to put the door down a little bit.
Yeah. Oh, sure. Gotcha.
There you go, right there.
Right there.
Get something set. Push the. Let me push the stars.
Where do you want
it? So it stops up.
There you go. That's it. Watch out.
All right.
Watch out. Look at that box.
Yep.
I think that's how it's going to go. Hold on. Yeah, what's this right here? Wait, that's the. And this extension is too long.
You know, let me back it up just a little bit. Can we pick it up and spin it?
No.
What? Like if I pulled the 10 and I pulled it my way, like look at this.
Wait, we got it. We're snagging on this.
Try to lift that up a little bit.
Oh, we're snagging. This is still hooked up.
How do you disconnect? How do you disconnect the shows?
I can see it. I'll just jack it.
Just yank it?
Yeah.
Okay. I could probably here.
There you go. Nice. Okay, perfect. A little more?
Let me get on the other side. Okay, ready?
Yep.
Nice.
All right.
Watch out, I'm gonna drop it. Watch your fingers.
Yep, go for it.
I'll drop it down so you can open the door.
Yep.
Go ahead. Just let it rest there right now. Can we open the door now?
Yep.
Hey, hold the door for me.
Hi.
Nice. That's good.
Got it.
Yeah. So we got this. This out of the way. Engine's out, guys.
Party.
Good thing I came all the way down here.
Right?
Yep. Seemed like a great idea until the sun started to come down. Like, ah, sound big.
Oh. Yeah. All right. Pull it out, Corey.
Look at that. Oh, watch the power cable up for the garage extension. We gotta go.
Oh, yeah, I gotta go lower.
Yep. Good.
All right, let's pull it out.
All right, here we go. Look at that.
Nice. Done. Engine's out. Dirty high five, Corin.
Yep.
Good stuff. Oh, thank you.
Oh, look at that. What'd you get?
Nice. Some Angry Orchard guys. Oh. This is our friend, John. John, get on camera. Come here. Say hi. Where's the camera? Get over here.
Hi.
Hello, guys. This is John. Come here. He drives a Blackboard SX.
Where's that?
Oh, the engine was still moving. So now what are we gonna do with this engine, Corey?
We're gonna put it on.
Call Seth, dude. You'll come running.
Hey, golf club, like, business spec. Nice job, guys. I came here. Dude, made it happen. Jesus Christ. Here, let's go through some.
Go ahead. Wow, that camera makes it look far brighter than it actually is around.
Yeah. Whoa! All right, Paco, let's look at some questions here.
Questions. Safety first. Sam still have a WRX? Well, now he has an STI.
Sam bought an STI. Here, let's turn around and come this way. Soon.
There you go. I don't know why you're trying to put it over there, but there you go. So, success. Thank you, guys. Casper, is that an old Skyline out there? Where? No. Wish.
What, the SBX? Or...
Oh, speaking of which,
I gotta put your engine cover down.
Matt Powers has a pizza sponsor. What the hell? Matt Powers has a pizza sponsor?
Yeah.
Cool. I want a pizza sponsor too. Hey, Matt, if you're watching, hook it up.
What's that?
Well, we rolled in the driveway, so it's not too bad.
What are we doing with the old motor?
Selling it.
We're selling it. Who wants a KA double cam?
Probably Seth, but he'll probably lowball you.
Yeah, no. I have a task.
Zombie Burt Reynolds livery.
I'll be pretty bitching. Zombie Bart Reynolds? That's like super manly.
Hell yeah.
So do we have what's going on here?
Not yet. Soon.
Close the door.
What's that?
Take take the air out of the tires. That's a good one, Jason. The problem is to fit the hoist under the lift, we have to lift the whole thing. So we got it out. It worked pretty good. Most workplace accidents can be prevented with proper safety gear.
Oh yeah, with
You gotta stay sharp with the helmet.
What if the thing would have fell on my face?
Well, you got it out.
Who won the contest?
The one on the road. That's not Skyline. It's a 280Z. Oh, the SVX.
Only if you stressing a Trans Am.
Yeah! Yeah! Boogity, 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 boogity! Got it out.
All right, so let's do the giveaways, Paco.
Oh, well, giveaway was with Instagram.
Yeah, so
have to check out the...
Let's check Instagram real quick. Let's call a winner and let's shut this down.
Let me get
the guys out on their Saturday night.
Okay, so John right here.
What did I do?
He's not
Let John be the judge.
John be the judge.
Who's so what we're going to do is we're going to have John here since he wasn't here for the first half. He's going to pick the best picture under hashtag Roofless Garage.
All right.
And those will be the winner of the Hoonigan decals as well as the new Hoonigan.
So let's see. Hashtag Roofless Garage. We have Ken and Campbell. We have Scumbag Alec. I guess they're both together.
Right.
Same, pretty much same photo, just different guy.
Yeah, except he's out of focus.
Mustang.
Nice.
Sponsored by Monster. Nice.
Moose are good. I like
Zombie those. Danny George.
Luke Foyer. Yeah. I don't know how to say that, but
yeah. So like, Spanish.
Go get him, guy.
He's got
his little bit, his little kid watching.
You can't have your kid that close to the TV,
his name?
Man. He's gonna get all cross-eyed and stuff.
Macaroni cheese. Ed Pearson.
It's a great action photo.
Show the camera to show the people the camera too.
Oh, there's so many of them, but I gotta get the camera close. Josh B. YT.
Excellent.
Dirty Hands. Sin Racing with a pretty big bushy beard.
Okay, well.
He's got Ted going on the back.
I can't grow a beard, so I'm jealous.
Ken Gilbert drifting.
Apparently, you talk with your hands a lot, Corey.
Yeah, I'm showing my hands.
Showing that his hands were dirty.
Look at it. I did that.
Look at that. Ty was showing his split action.
He does
splits. That was from last time. He was showing his splits. Swing and low. Yeah, horizontally. Right. It's on the hand thing.
Yeah. Yeah. My hands.
I call it jazz hands.
Yeah, I call it jazz hands.
It's more the poop position.
Yep, panty dropping as for teams.
Well, yeah. Panty dropping with the poop. Yeah. That's good. That's good work.
Nick Vert. There you go.
Okay.
And I think
that's
it.
Me. So
pretty much you can see.
All right. I personally
don't say the name yet.
Don't say it. You like that one?
I think that's
the only. The only thing is that one's from last times.
Why you gotta limit me, man?
Well, not you, but we're like putting something from this live stream.
Uh huh. All right.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. Moment of truth.
I'm going with the poopy face.
Yeah, the poopy face.
That wins. Well,
that's the thing, Corey.
Let's see. I'm with that, or I'm with the back. Uh-huh. Or I'm with good. I mean,
good. Yeah, I like that because of the fact that.
Yep.
Okay. Yeah. Oh.
Let's see.
All right. Paco?
So, is it official?
This one?
Let's make it official.
This one?
Since John was not a part of this first half.
Oh, we got to get the camera closer, probably. Right.
The winner goes to.
Stickers.
And for both?
Oh, it was
one and both?
Okay, let's do a stickers for one thing.
Sticker for one thing.
Sticker.
Goes to
Go Get Him guy.
Woo!
With this kid watching.
Winner.
You get it? There you go. A little higher.
Burp, burp, burp.
So if you want to send a private message to Paco's going to put a message together for you. We'll get your information. We'll ship these out.
The Hoonigan stickers.
And now for the lanyard.
For the lanyard, what are they doing for the lanyard?
John?
Like a best second photo?
Should we do that one because he's been watching? Been part of it.
He chose that one and he's been watching since day one.
Yep, so this is it. This goes to a loyal watcher, very active on the chats.
And
it goes to Mr. Splits himself, Ty. So we'll send you a message, Ty, and we'll send you that, the new Hoonigan lanyard out. So
what's it, the Gymkhana, right?
Yep, the new Gymkhana lanyard for the Hoonigans.
Ooh, fancy.
Yep.
So fancy.
Look at that. So you guys go.
All right, so that's it, guys. Thanks for helping us out. What else?
That'll be it. Next time we're probably gonna be taking the car to 18 Fab. We gotta be starting rolling putting the roll cage on it. And what else? Probably we can probably do one where like finish trimming the whole front.
Yeah, we'll cut
so
the front.
So we can get it get it ready for the cage.
Do not correct him.
Clean everything on the interior or something.
Yeah. Perfect.
And it'll be good. Boom.
Thank you guys for tuning in.
Rubens
Garage.
And
see you again.
Stopping broadcast. Now.
Bye-bye.
Later.
Bye-bye now.